one 15-ounce can of pumpkin. We're gonna use 1/4 cup of brown sugar, 3/4 cup of granulated sugar. I'm opting to use the stevia this time, just so we have less calories, but you can use either one. 1/2 cup of melted butter. And we're gonna mix up those ingredients. Now, do y'all think that generic brand is as good as the name brand? What do y'all think? Now we're gonna add 2 cups of all-purpose flour. I'm just using the generic again. And that's 1 teaspoon of baking soda. We're gonna also go in with some cinnamon. We need 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. Nutmeg, 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. We're gonna take 1/2 teaspoon of salt now. I'm using the Himalayan pink salt because apparently it is better for you, but you could use any kind of salt. What kind do you prefer? And we're gonna mix our dry ingredients. And there's one other thing I need for this, some eggs. There's a couple there in the fridge. Would you grab that?
Please? Eggs out of the fridge.
You'll need 2 eggs for this.
All right, here they are, 2 eggs.
Thank you. It's okay, extra calcium, right?
Yes.
And we're gonna stir our dry ingredients and then add those to the mixture. Add that in, and then we're gonna give everything a mix in our pot. Now, you could use separate bowls to mix if you'd like, but you know what? This is just less dishes to clean up, so I figured this makes more sense. Y'all been saying I never cook anything from scratch because we normally just do quick and easy recipes, but I thought we would do some scratch recipes today. Are y'all a fan of pumpkin, or would you rather use another fall flavor, like maybe apple or sweet potato? What do you think? Okay. All right, look at that beautiful batter. Now we're gonna add some chocolate chips. Now I'm using the sugar-free chocolate chips. These are sweetened with stevia, but you can use regular ones. This is just a little bit of a healthier option for pumpkin bread. And then we're gonna fold that in. What toppings would you like for your pumpkin bread? Would you opt for the chocolate chips, or maybe you would do pecans or pecans? I say pecans, Kyle says pecans. What do you call them? Or you could use cream cheese. For this version, we are using chocolate chips.
Yay. 4, 3.
That looks perfect. I just saved a few extra chocolate chips to sprinkle on top, and that's it. And we're gonna bake this on high inside of our crock pot for 3 hours. And now we're gonna just add a paper towel on the top, or you could use a tea towel. Lid goes on. That paper towel will help collect the condensation. It'll keep the bread from getting too moist. Bake it for 3 hours on high, and then it's time to taste test. Oh, we got a visitor.
He's excited.
He heard that I had some pumpkin.
He loves pumpkin.
Did you know pumpkin is great for dogs? You want a treat, buddy? Sit, sit for me, sit.
Mama.
What's your puppy's favorite treat? Ours love pumpkin. In fact, we actually made some dog treats using pumpkin and whole wheat flour and applesauce.
I like it, Mama.
All right, y'all. Pumpkin bread is ready. Come look at this. I'm so pleased with how it turned out. And we ended up making this from scratch, and we also made it a little bit lighter and healthier because we ended up using the stevia instead of regular sugar, and we use sugar-free chocolate chips. But you don't have to do that. If you want to make it with regular sugar, you can. That's just what our preference was this time around. Let's see if I can get this out of the pot. Now, remember, you could use parchment paper, and then you could just lift it out, but I think I'm going to be able to get it without the parchment paper.
Okay.
I'm just going to get underneath here. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's breaking.
Okay.
How can we do this so it doesn't break apart?
Wow, we should have thought this through.
I'm gonna flip it.
You're gonna flip the whole thing?
I'm gonna flip it.
All right, here we go. I got a plate. All right, here we go. I'll put the plate in.
Okay.
Right there. You flip it onto the plate. All right. How does it look? That's the upside down version.
Okay.
Now you're gonna flip it.
Okay, hold on.
Oh my goodness. We were doing so well too. Okay.
Okay, now. Try to flip that. You can't do that, can you?
What are you doing?
We're just showing them everything, aren't we?
We can edit all this out, right?
But maybe they don't want me to edit. Maybe They want me to keep everything in so they can see all of our struggles.
So don't, everything we did right now is the wrong way to do it, okay. Basically, right?
But, okay, y'all, we did it.
Okay.
We did it. It's a little bit broken right there, yep. But it's going to be delicious.
Hey, Mistie, do you know how to fix a broken pumpkin?
A broken pumpkin?
Yes.
How do you fix a broken pumpkin?
With a pumpkin patch. A pumpkin patch. It's good,
that's
right?
That's a good one. Okay, we're just gonna cut it right in the middle. Let's see how.
Look at that.
This looks so good. I'm just gonna take a bite.
All right, I'm coming in. Hold on. All right, I'm coming in.
All right.
Here we go.
Here you go. You take that piece.
All right, here we go.
Doesn't this look delicious?
I am so excited about this.
It's so soft and moist.
Okay.
Oh my, this is good. It's not too sweet. I use dark chocolate chips. It's a really, really nice combo. Have you ever tried the pumpkin with chocolate?
I was concerned about the chocolate. I thought that was gonna wreck the whole thing, but it's good, yeah.
Y'all gotta try this. Homemade pumpkin bread in the crock pot. Just don't forget the parchment paper.
Mm-hmm.